Hello, welcome to the joint production of The Citizen and News Clip. Today we are going to discuss about the UP elections and we are joined by Seema Mustafa, who is editor-in-chief of The Citizen and has been writing on Uttar Pradesh for more than 3 decades now. Seema, welcome to our program. So before we move further, there's a quagmire that is developing within the Samajwadi Party. What do you have to say about it?
You know, sometimes you feel that the chaos could be actually an opportunity. And I think this time in UP, this could become an opportunity for Akhilesh Yadav. I mean, of course, if it had happened much earlier, it would have been slightly more beneficial. But the point is that he, by actually standing firm on issues of corruption, as symbolized by the legislators who are corrupt and whom Mulayam is supporting, against criminalization, again symbolized by legislators that his father is supporting, who he does not want to be given tickets. He has managed to, one, acquire the clean anti-corruption, anti-criminalization image, along with doing development work, for which he anyway was getting some brownie points.
So, you mean to say that the entire arithmetic of incorporating the Qaumi Ekta Dal and then Atiq Ahmed and shielding all these people, that has backfired for Mulayam Singh Yadav?
I think so. I think Mulayam Singh, for obvious reasons and reasons of commission more than omission, has managed to get that baggage of corruption, goons, gundaism, anti-law and order attached to himself. So by ridding his father, getting rid of his father as it were, Akhilesh has actually divested himself of that baggage. That baggage is not sticking to him. So that is an amazingly clever move, and he's done it very respectfully. He's always ensured that his photo ops with his father, even in these bad days, has always shown him as very deferential, very respectful, whereas Mulayam Singh has been speaking against his son to anyone who meets him.
So there's also news that there's a coalition chances between the Congress, RLD and Samajwadi Party. Do you see that developing, and if that happens, what impact will it have?
Congress has been trying to ride piggyback on anybody. So first they tried Mayawati. At that time it seemed that Mayawati was, you know, actually going to give a very good fight, which he still might. I mean, it's still too early to say anything. But at that time Samajwadi, because of Mulayam Singh and Amar Singh, was really down. So they tried with Mayawati, she said no way. Then they tried with Samajwadi, now Mulayam is against it. But Akhilesh has always been for it. And from the reports that we get, there is a good equation between him and between Rahul Gandhi, the Congress. So the Congress itself has no vote. And the Congress itself is not going to bring anything of its own to the table. And if the Congress was going to contest separately, and individually, it might remain at this low figure of under 10, 5, 4, 3, you know, anything. But if it attaches itself to Akhilesh and in this new kind of resurgence, then, you know, the youth factor together, looking for a cohesive government, all that will then start making the waves.
So do you think there is a coalition building up between Muslims, Yadavs and the Jats, which may be beneficial for Samajwadi Party?
I think this time it's not going to be very, you know, the usual known equations. And even the report in the media, though it has said that the Jats are angry, it depends where the Jats go at the end of the day. So I'm not going to count too much on who's going where, but what I think that Akhilesh needs to actually win now, at a time when the BJP is projecting Modi as somebody who is cutting across all caste lines, not that he is, but that's the projection, that he is anti-corruption because of demonetization, which is might be, might not be, is not, but then that's the projection, and that he is anti-criminalization. So you have this clean prime minister image, and so if you vote for him, you vote for a good government, right? This time, because of the position he has taken, Akhilesh has emerged as the anti-corrupt, anti-criminal, anti-pro-development. The same card has come to Akhilesh Yadav. And Akhilesh Yadav is seen by all communities in UP, whether they vote for him or not, as a good guy. He's a guy who's for development. He's got that mass appeal, like you said. He reaches out to the youth, and he's a local. And he's somebody they've seen for the last 5 years. They feel he's responsive, he's sensitive. It isn't that he's only going to the Yadav or only going to the Muslim. He's accessible to all. Now that is a very strong image and a very strong plus, which can really stand for him. He'll have to, if he has to win, he has to cut across all.
You've pointed out a very important thing, that Modi is being projected as someone who has a clean image.
Yeah.
And if you look in Uttar Pradesh and the BJP, they don't have any face to project in Uttar Pradesh, so they are projecting Prime Minister at the face of Uttar Pradesh elections. So what is BJP actually banking on? Because if we look at the news reports, the entire demonetization seems to have fallen flat.
I don't know whether it's actually fallen flat. It has definitely fallen flat amongst the thinking sections of people who can, and the economists who have actually pointed out the kind of impact that's happening on the informal sector. All the migrants who've gone back into UP, who have been working, say, in Punjab and other states. So all that is, of course, happening. To what extent it's happening is something on the ground we still have to gauge, and probably these elections will help us in gauging that. Mainly also because the BJP's campaign is very high, you know, and they are actually, their perceptions are very based on falsehood, based on anything and not on facts. They are being able to project that, look, we've done it, we've hit the corruption. But what I'm trying to say is that even if you take that perception to be the perception that people are admitting to, their vote bank and others are looking at, Akhilesh Yadav has actually proven that on the ground by going for a split in the Samajwadi party regardless of everything. So that ticket, as it were, has gone to him as well. So the BJP is not alone. And like you said, he is a homegrown boy. He is not the Prime Minister of India sitting in Delhi. And in state elections, people want their chief minister there. And they like to know who their chief minister is, as you can see in Bihar. The BJP didn't have a chance because it was so many factions that they couldn't project a face. And Nitish Kumar romped home. That was one of the factors. There were many factors. Similarly, in UP also, in northern India, in these poor states, people like to know who they're voting for.
Do you think that BJP will again go back to its old politics of communalizing the society to win UP election?
They haven't given that up, by the way. Demonetization is for you and me and for a certain class who they are addressing, you know, the slightly informed. On the ground, whether it's particularly in Western UP, the politics of communalism is continuing. The RSS cadres are there, all their various outfits are there. They're having house-to-house campaigns, door-to-door campaigns. And that hate and that anger, they're continuously working on that, you know. So that hasn't stopped. The BJP cannot ever get away from that divisive, anti-Indian politics of theirs.
Now let's come to Mayawati. She's the only person who has announced her candidates till now. But there's not much hype about her entire campaign. We can't see her going and addressing public meetings. What actually is she doing?
Mayawati doesn't do that. See, that's why I'm saying one doesn't ever rule Mayawati out. You might not rule her in, but you can never rule her out. I remember when she last won the election, everybody didn't even see her on the ground. She is a quiet vote. She has a vote which is the Dalit, the most oppressed vote in UP that does not speak. Except for the Jatav now. If you go into Western UP, you'll find them speaking out a bit. But the Dalit doesn't essentially tell you what his preference is, particularly when the other campaign is very aggressive, right? And today the Muslim is also not speaking. Now, it's very clear that Dalit and Muslim is what she's looking at. She has sent, from a woman who's never, at times, never given even one seat to a Muslim, has fielded 100 plus. So the point is that there is a certain, but she's also fielded upper caste. So she's trying very hard to get that consolidation behind her, which, by the way, I think she would have had the split in the Samajwadi not taken place. If Mulayam was still calling the shots and if Akhilesh was still listening to him, then the chances of the vote shifting to Mayawati were very high. And till 2 months ago, 3 months ago, many of us who were looking at UP closely got the feeling that she is going to be moving ahead. But now, with this kind of a change that has happened in the Samajwadi, which is why I said it can be an opportunity, you might find a landslide support for Akhilesh Yadav. I don't believe there's going to be anything hung, you know. I believe that in UP, in a time which is so highly political, where the stakes are so high, where people have been made to believe that their stakes are even higher than they might be, people are not going to vote, you know, piecemeal.
This would be my last question. So whoever wins, don't you think it would be end of politics for the opposition, be it BSP or SP, and BJP is going to emerge out as the second most important party in Uttar Pradesh?
No, I don't think so. I think that even if you look at the 2014 general elections, when the BJP seemed to have swept UP in parliament, you had the vote percentages of the Samajwadi and the BSP very high. So these people are there. They're there for good. I mean, they're there. They have a base. They have a very, very strong base. Mayawati also doesn't have age against her to that extent. And Akhilesh Yadav is, if not this election, then he's got the next general election to look at, right? And I think that UP is going to carry many lessons, and it is going to carry lessons for the opposition. It's going to carry lessons for the BJP, regardless of who wins or loses. And it is going to pave the way towards the general elections, one way or the other. And we must remember that in all the elections since 2014, everywhere where there has been a regional party, the BJP has lost. It is only one when it is fighting the Congress, which carries a very strong lesson for all of us who look at the BJP and the Congress as an alternative.
Thanks a lot for giving us your time, and as these things proceed, we'll be coming back to you on such issues. Thanks a lot. Thank you for watching our program.